GCS horrible.
All right, guys, that final play, Rich, you come around third, ball goes to first. What are you thinking right there?
Score. I looked over to see what the call was at first and saw I was safe and knew I had to make it. I knew it was going to be close, but went wide and got in there.
Phil, did you sort of see the same thing? You say anything to him as he was rounding third?
Let's go. That's it. Give him a wave and let's go. You got to go. That was it. I think I was saying, come on, Rich. Come on, Rich.
Yep.
That was it. But you go through things like that in your head standing over there. You know, base hit. Obviously, things are – I'm looking at the outfielders. But pressure play like that, you know, it's where hustle pays off. The hustle paid off for Macklin there and Siegel and him running hard. And Mack running hard made it all work. So it was a great effort.
Did you wait to see if Macklin was safe?
I mean, no.
I guess it really didn't matter because there were two outs. Because it was a bang, bang, bang.
Two outs, and it was a tough play for
him.
Strikes. Yeah. But he's moving. He's coming in on the ball. There's always a good chance of a short hop or something, a bobble. We're sending him. You know, he calls him out. Clay's dead. If not, we're going to try it.
Macklin did strike out again tonight, but when he was sitting here last week, you had mentioned how you just want to put the ball in play. He gets on board tonight with an error, and then that last infield single. Is that kind of what you've been trying to get him to do?
Yeah, especially with two strikes. But none of that happens unless you put it in play. You know, but part of being a hitter or being part of the offense is putting pressure on their defense, and striking out doesn't do that. You know, walking and battling with two strikes, finding a way to put a ball in play, no matter what the situation, that's putting pressure on, especially when there's base runners like that last inning there. So, yes, to answer your question, that's a little bit more of what we're working on.
Talk about the suicide. I don't think anybody's ever going to accuse Ben Waldrick of being a sprinter, but you decided to send him on the suicide squeeze.
Yeah, we had to shake something up. You know, we are. I don't want to talk anything negative. Facts are facts, but you know, we're last in the league in hitting. Somehow we're first in runs scored and leading the league in striking out as an offense, but leading the league in walking as an offense. So we're just that team right now finding ways to win, and I'm okay with that. We have to get better. There's going to be times down the stretch where bases loaded. I thought the biggest thing to me offensively tonight was the bases loaded, one out, and we don't get a run
in the third inning.
And the whole season we've been that way for the most part. We get a few here, a few there, but you know, they're not carrying a lot of pitchers. We had a chance to really knock their starter around early on in that game. And as an offense, as a unit, that's when you should be in attack mode. That's your chance early in the game. One, to steal momentum. Two, to get in their pen early and making a long series for them. So, we're still a work in progress offensively.
Richard, Webster's on. His unorthodox delivery, was that kind of tough for you guys to pick up?
He was kind of like a sidewinder, but then came back over the top. It wasn't too tricky, I guess. I mean, he didn't really hide the ball very well. And coming out of his hand, you could pretty much see what it was. It's just he was locating the off-speed and getting us to swing over the changeup and curveball. And guy like that, you kind of just have to jump on the fastball when it's there, because if you don't get anything else, he's just going to throw a lot of slop at you.
I guess your middle at-bats didn't go very well, but
yeah.
Nice way to bookend
a
game with a homer in the first and then a
double. It's funny how baseball works. I mean, first AB hit the home run, and then the next three – strike out and get up there and top of the ninth, top of the tenth, or bottom of the ninth, bottom of the tenth, whatever it was. And putting you back in that position where you got the high and then it just beat you down to the lowest low, and you got to find a way to stay that middle ground, and got the opportunity, hit the double, and got the win.
Talk about Kelly tonight, and he's making this Frontier League stuff look easy.
Well, he's kind of the unsung hero here, I would say. He deserved an ice bath, too. I mean, the kid's, what, two runs? Three runs? Was that an earned run for him tonight?
No.
No. So two runs on his own throwing error, his first outing, you know, but strikes, does the change up whenever he wants. But the biggest thing is just, he, for the most part, he keeps it down. He commands. He's a little funky like their starter. Who's he's fun to watch. It's going to be fun to watch him grow. And you know, for him, as funky and deceptive as he is, and being able to throw that change up whenever he wants, if he just commands his own, he's going to be very successful at this level.
Okay.
Good job, Rich.
Thanks, guys.